Konnichiwa, Mina. I'm Star. I love pictures. I love editing them, making them, and shooting them. But I think this anime took that last part a little too literally. Let's check out Speed Grapher. The show was created in 2005 by Gonzo. No! Idiot. Gonzo is a Japanese anime studio. They've also animated some titles like Witchblade, Kaleidostar, and Samurai 7, among others. Speed Grapher was directed by Kunishia Sugishima. Its 24-episode-long series ran from April till October of 2005. Between September 2005 to September 2006, it was adopted into a manga by Tomozo. Our lead character is Satsumi Saiga. He's a former war photographer turned tabloid photographer, taking pictures of politicians and whatnot. He comes to investigate a secret fetish club for the ultra-wealthy called the Roppongi Club. He manages to sneak into the club and tries to photograph the club's goddess, 15-year-old Kagura, a poor, exploited, and neglected girl. Kagura, when she is the goddess, is under some influence. She has basically no control of what's going on and only remembers it the next day as a bad dream. Kagura, as the goddess, kisses Saiga, and soon he finds out, for whatever means, Kagura's saliva can give people bizarre abilities relating to their secret desires, fetishes, and obsessions. Saiga's being his camera, we soon find out what his new ability is. All that Kagura wants is to be free, like the girl in the poster she has seen around town. After an accidental half-rescue from Saiga, Kagura begs him to help her be free. As the series goes on, Kagura and Saiga are stuck between a game of cat and mouse. Tsutengu, the right-hand or leader of the club, goes after her. Without Kagura, there would halfway be no club. Since many club members strive for the honor of becoming gifted via Kagura's power. As the series goes on with this game of back and forth, we have other characters of interest, like Hibaria Ginza. She works for the Tokyo Police Department and is in love with Saiga, always wanting him and protecting him. But she's actually quite a vicious policewoman, not really following by the book. Anytime she wants information and doesn't get it, she says she'll claim it was self-defense and shoot her suspect. She does get jealous when Kagura comes into the picture, but finds her happiness at the end of the series. We also have the Euphoric, humans that have been infected with a never-named retrovirus and then exposed to the catalyst within Kagura, granting them their powers. They kind of play the monster of the day, though most of them last longer than one episode. Each of these Euphorics have been told to get Kagura back to the club by Tsutengu, who is also a Euphoric. Finally, at the end of the series, we get a final showdown between Saiga and Tsutengu. Tsutengu reveals his euphoric power, the ability to manipulate his own blood and use it at will to attack and defend. Does the series end in a happy ending? You're gonna have to see it to find out. Overall, Speed Grapher is an interesting anime. Some twists and turns keep your attention and have you wondering what will happen in the end. a decent series to have on your shelf. I'm Star. Sayonara, Mina.
Yeah.